this is Julie from Bedford TV. And hi, thank you. Hi, nice to have some Bedford
TV. Hi, everybody.
Hi. We have some very exciting news that we're celebrating at Bedford TV. We have won yet another award. And this award is specifically for our show, The Wrestling Connection. And I have next to me the host of The Wrestling Connection, Ken Hill. And on my other side, I have Greg Dolan, who is the producer and the director of the show and the executive director of Bedford TV altogether. We just received word that we won the award. The specific category is Best General Talk Show. And it was awarded to us by an industry organization called ACM, which stands for the Alliance Community Media, which is like the Oscars for local television. Yeah, so this is huge news, so I thought we'd take some time and interview both of you.
Yeah, my uncle even said on Facebook, my uncle Andy even said it was like winning an Emmy.
Yeah, like winning an Emmy. Yeah, that's a better analogy than winning an Emmy. So, Greg, why don't we start with you? How did you find Ken? How did Ken find you? How'd the show get started?
It was a dark and stormy night. I don't know, Ken. How do we meet? I think you came down to the station and just said you wanted to do a show.
Well, no, actually, I was still working at the old Brugger's.
Ah, yes.
Not the new one with Jumbo Juice, the old one. And you and Brian Dorrington were actually regular guests in there.
Oh, he's right over there. I wonder if he wants to come up. Nope, he doesn't. All right.
No, he doesn't.
We try.
Okay. Well, anyway, Brian and I actually talked at length. Like, he mentioned he worked for Bedford TV. I said I was looking for something. And he even asked me, okay, so what do you like? Well, I like sports and pro wrestling. And he jumped right on it. Told me that he loved pro wrestling, too, when he was, like, going through middle school and high school. Kind of fell out of touch with it. And I thought, okay. Maybe I can come on and do maybe like a talk show or something. I can talk about like my passion for wrestling, and he was all over it. Next thing you know, like 135 episodes later, here we are. Like,
interesting. Hold on, Julie. I'm gonna let you interview him. I'm gonna check on our camera audio.
So 135 episodes.
Yeah, this is
Now, how long did it take you to film 135 episodes?
Well, actually, we do one every week. We do a new episode every week. We started all the way back in February of 2014. So we've been doing this for literally 135 weeks.
That is amazing. Congratulations.
I mean, two and two-thirds years. It's been unbelievable. I mean, our first year, we had, we made the front page of the Bedford Minuteman.
That's right.
End of the second season, we had the award for 100, for like Centennial Club, the first Bedford TV show to ever produce 100 episodes.
That's right.
And now, third year, we're getting an award. So we keep climbing and climbing and climbing. We just keep doing more and more. We're making history.
Give us a little bit of an overview of your show. When people tune in, what are they going to learn?
Well, really, what people are going to learn is just how deep my passion for professional wrestling goes. It's not just a matter of, oh, hey, here comes another wrestling nut who's so lost and thinks reality is fake and wrestling is real. That's not what you're going to see. What you're going to see is three people, myself, Zach Martinkus, Julian Warren, three people who are very passionate about the professional wrestling industry, and we're giving that passion back to the community. Because as you may or may not know, Zach and I both grew up with Asperger's syndrome, high functioning autism. And what professional wrestling did for us was that it gave us the ability to read body language. Like, we would watch the matches, the promos wrestlers would talk about, and we'd be able to like anticipate, oh, what are they going to say next? What are they going to do next? Is this guy going to jump that guy? Who's going to win the match? Like, you can see an ending for a match coming. It's so fun anticipating the twists and the turns. That's why I love wrestling.
Right.
It's just when it tells a good narrative, a good story. That's what I love about professional wrestling. Zach just loves like how fantastic the world of wrestling is.
Now, besides you and Zach, do you have other people on your show?
Well, we have, like I said, we have Julian. He lives up in Fall River near Zach. It's quite a drive for both of them, but I give them all the credit in the world for being able to make it when they can. Of course, we have you on the show. We have Greg on the show. We had Brian on for the first two seasons. We've had a couple of our lovely interns on for a few shows. So I try to welcome everyone in the Bedford TV crew to try to jump in, be a part of the WK crew, as I like to call them. It's always a fun time, always guaranteed excitement, hilarity. I mean, it's like I said in the last interview, even if you're not a huge wrestling buff like Zach, Julian, and I are, it's a funny half hour. It's a hilarious way to kill half an hour.
Now, Greg, do you know that a lot of your viewers are giving you good feedback? This is a popular show, an award-winning show. What are you hearing from the fans?
You know, people love the wrestling connection, even non-wrestling fans. Myself, I am not a professional wrestling fan. If anyone's watched the show, they can probably figure that out pretty fast. The show's really wacky and off the wall and fun and crazy, and I think it embraces all the great things about public access. I remember we went out in the field to do some interviews and to ask people what their favorite parts of Bedford TV are, and a few people said the wrestling connection. Maybe not the demographic I would have expected to. There were some people who didn't seem like your stereotypical wrestling fans who were big fans of Kenny's show, and I think that just goes to show that it's a fun show. It's a pro wrestling show, but it's a fun show no matter what your interests are.
It is, because, I do driving on the side. I do taxing on the side for a job. And, when I bring up the fact that I do, a wrestling TV show, the first thing I hear is that, oh, hey, I used to watch that. I used to watch that back. Just like what Brian said. You used to watch it in middle school, high school. I kind of fell out of touch with it. And I always mention them, well, catch a show. You never know. You might just find the spark to get back into it. I mean, even something Brian, I remember Brian said this in the article we did for the Bedford
Brian,
Internet.
Right there. That Brian guy right Roynton. There. Yeah.
He said it got him back into wrestling because he saw how passionate we were about it. Just inspiring to get back into the whole, WWE mix, the whole pro wrestling mix. And I'm just happy because that's what I want to do. Because pro wrestling gave so much to me and Zach, the ability to read body language as autistics, we wanted to give that devotion and passion and energy back to the Bedford community and to the New England community and the world beyond.
Right. Now, how did you describe the style of the show a moment ago? What was the word you used?
I don't remember, but I'm sure it was brilliant.
We finally talked him onto the show.
Here he is.
It's like Bloody Mary. You say his name enough times, he jumps right out at you.
So joining us now is Brian Dorrington Jr. He unfortunately does not work at Bedford TV anymore, but while he was here, one of his biggest legacies was being the creator, the executive producer of Wrestling Connection.
Well, Ken was the creator. I was the facilitator of Ken's ideas. So it's Ken's show. He created it, but Greg and I both, helped him and launched it. And he took it his own direction. But we helped. The funnest memories I have at Bedford TV were of the Wrestling Connection and were making the promos. Because those got pretty outrageous, and those were super fun.
I honestly wish we had a big TV up here so we could show some of those.
Could you reenact one for me?
Oh no, my favorite one that these two did, a promo they produced, was actually for our first pay-per-view, which was WrestleMania 30, and we didn't have an official title for it at the time. We called it the WrestleMania Roundtable, and what they did in their infinite creativity was they took Zach and they took a still shot of Zach and my head and superimposed it on these little miniature horse chess pieces. So it was just us galloping out to like medieval fair music and just we're galloping along, it's nice, and suddenly it's like a huge explosion, and that pretty much set the theme for every promo ever. That pretty much anything.
Yeah, that was one of the first ones.
Pretty much anything on the Wrestling Connection will end with an explosion.
Yes.
Either start with one or it'll end with one.
Thankfully, they're CGI and not real. But Before we close out, I just want to end with one real quick thought from the Bedford TV perspective and that side of things. That if you're interested in doing a show, if you have an interest like of any kind, like Ken was a huge pro wrestling fan. He came in, wanted to do a show. We made it really easy for him, and now a few years later, he's winning awards, doing all this great stuff, and it's been, from what I can tell, a great experience for him. So I would encourage you, if you have any kind of interest at all, any niche kind of thing that you're really like, I'm passionate about this and I want to explore this and do a show about it, then just come on down. We'll make it easy for you. It'll be fun. And
If you like sports, if you even like talking about politics, news, anything you want.
Honestly, if you're really passionate about dirt, we'll do a show about dirt. Come on.
About dirt, about the earth, trees. About nature. We even have a musician who does nature sounds. So if you want to be like him and get back to nature, that's perfect.
Yeah, so come on down.
One more question for Greg. Yes. Has Bedford any other of Bedford TV programming won awards?
Yes. Trying to dodge some stuff over here. Yes, a lot of shows have won awards. I'm trying to think off the top of my head. We have a waffle, which is very proud. Yeah, our interns in the last few years have won awards. I know last year, Alan, Marco, and Jared all won the award for a promo they did for the station. The year before, the interns did a piece on Citizen Scholarship Foundation. And, all won. Oh, Cooking Show. Munch. Yeah. With Avery. Connery Kid. All sorts of shows.
As well as Best Small Station several times.
Yes. Yes.
Both national and Northeast.
Yes. So, yeah, we're pretty cool. So I think we're going to wrap it up because we got some musicians coming up next, and I want to give them time to set up. So thanks for joining us again, Ken. Check out the Wrestling Connection live on Thursdays around noon, depending on when someone wakes up. And check it out live on YouTube and live on our channels.
And of course, on our website, thewrestlingconnection.com. And remember, everyone, be connected. Get connected, stay connected.